Hello children, let's begin with the next topic of the manufacturing industries, that is industrial pollution and environmental degradation. Topic is, that is your air pollution in this. As you all are familiar with the pollution, different pollutions are there, that is your air pollution, noise pollution, thermal pollution and even your water pollution. So air pollution is caused by the poisonous gases, that is the sulfur dioxide and carbon monoxide. Even by the airborne particulate matter, dust, spray, mist, smoke, they also causes the air pollution. Major contributors in this air pollution is brick kilns, paper industry, burning fossil fuels, they gives the smokes and that causes the pollution. Toxic gas that leaks has the hazardous effect. Example, Bhopal gas tragedy that occurred in the 1984 killed more than 3,000 people. And the recent gas tragedy that occurred in India, it was in the Visakhapatnam, the reserve gas, it was leaked, killing few people at that time in the month of the May. Next is water pollution caused by the organic and inorganic industrial waste. Culprits in this or the main contributors in this water pollution are pulp and paper industry, chemical, textile, dyeing, petroleum, refineries, even fertilizers and chemical industry, they all contribute to the water pollution. Steel slag, that is the waste that comes out of the steel when the steel is melted, okay, or it is smelted. So, when it is melted, silicates and oxides come out of it. So, when it cools down, it becomes solid. So, it is the major solid waste in the that causes the water pollution. Next is the thermal pollution. Culprits are nuclear power plants, weapon producing industries. There, if the pollution is caused by the thermal reactors, it can cause birth defects, and even also when the thermal pollution is caused, then the underground water is also contaminated because with the rainfall, that is the hydrological cycle or the water cycle. Because that polluted water comes to the back to the surface of the earth in the form of the rain and pollutes the underground water. Noise pollution, it causes hearing impairment, increased heart rate and blood pressure, basically caused by all the industries, even the vehicles we are having on the streets, that all causes the noise pollution. Loud noise is a noise pollution only. Industries, factory equipments, generators and the pneumatic saws, they all causes the, that is a noise pollution. Now, control on the environmental degradation. That is how we can control the environmental degradation or the pollution. That is reusing, recycling of the wastewater. It is necessary, that is whatever the wastewater is, even in our homes also, we should reuse it and recycle it. Rainwater harvesting should be done so that the minimum use of the underground water should be is there, and we can do the rainwater harvesting for using the water in our houses or in the industries also. Treating hot water effluents at three stages. First is primary treatment, that is done by the four processes. That is screening, means with the help of a large sieve to separate the solid and the liquid waste. Grinding, that is crushing the waste. Flocculation, changing them into a soft form and then decomposing it. Sedimentation, that is separating the waste and the liquid. Secondary treatment by biological process, that is decomposing the waste material with the help of the microorganisms. Last is the tertiary treatment by recycling the wastewater at different successive stages. Other measures are reduce smoke by using oil and gas instead of the coal, because coal gives more smoke in comparison to the oil and gas. Silencers should be fitted to the industries and to the generators also, so that they can cause less noise pollution. People can use earplugs also to avoid the noise pollution. Particulate matter can be reduced by fitting smoke absorbers. Electrostatic precipitators also, okay, so that smoke can be controlled.